If you've traveled to the Andaman Nicobar Islands recently, the one thing you could not have simply missed is the rapid expansion of strategic infrastructure there. For one, it's now possible to make a call and use your WhatsApp here, courtesy the submarine cable that was inaugurated by Prime Minister Modi in 2020. Before that, you would have to be really lucky if you got any signal on your phone. Now, under the watch of the Niti Aayog, the Port Blair Airport complex is being expanded. There's a transshipment port that is coming up in South Bay. There's a parallel to the coast mass rapid transport system that is coming up, and a free trade zone and warehousing complexes all coming up on the southwestern coast. The defence infrastructure is being expanded across the island. There is also a dazzling but equally worrying plan of converting Little Andaman, the fourth largest island in the archipelago, into the Singapore of India. I say worrying because it puts at risk Andaman Nicobar's fragile ecology and its rich flora and fauna, but that's a chat for another time. Why, after decades of resisting infrastructure development in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, of keeping it isolated, the government is waking up to its strategic importance. So much so that it also has a 10-year plan in place. First, a quick geography lesson. This is where the Andaman Nicobar Islands are located, deep south in the Bay of Bengal. Of the 572 islands in the archipelago, only 38 are inhabited. The 10-degree channel, an important shipping lane, separates Nicobar from Andaman. And right at the tip, India's southernmost outpost is Campbell Bay. This is where Indra Point is located. The Naval Air Base, INS Baz, is located here, and it has been upgraded into an aviation base, a place where all assets deployed to keep an eye on the Indian Ocean region come for refueling. A third naval base, INS Khosa, has been commissioned in the northern Andaman region. Some details of military infrastructure development are not public, but suffice to say that facilities are being created to accommodate more troops, more warships, airplanes on the island. The reason is China and its growing presence in the Indian Ocean region. China has been collecting vital information about the underwater operating environment in the region. China now has the largest navy in the world. It has commissioned 80 ships in the last 5 years alone. So this is very high quality naval presence that we are talking about. India needs to keep a close watch over China's ships and submarines. And the best place to do it from are the Andaman Nicobar Islands, your final frontier at sea, where cutting edge reconnaissance assets like the PTI need to be deployed more frequently than ever before. Now, warships positioned at strategic nodes on the islands can improve the effectiveness of your security missions. You need to be prepared for an enemy's intentions and not his capabilities. It's the important lesson that Ladakh has taught us. There are some very important shipping lanes that pass right under the nose of the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Campbell Bay, where the INS Baz runway is being extended and where a transshipment terminal is coming up, is India's southernmost air station. It overlooks the crucial Strait of Malacca and dominates the 6-degree channel shipping lane. Some 60,000 vessels move through the Strait of Malacca each year. Most of it are China's oil imports. In case a conflict with China breaks out, it's easy for India's Navy to choke the Malacca Strait and pressurize the Chinese. The number of bilateral and multilateral exercises with friendly navies in recent years is a proactive posture to tell the Chinese that we are here and that this is not the South China Sea where you can run riot, this is the Indian Ocean region. Over the years, Andaman Nicobar Islands have been the staging post for India's humanitarian efforts in the Bay of Bengal as well, something that has earned us immense goodwill across the region. For example, when Maldives was going through a water shortage, India's naval ships from the Andaman Nicobar Islands reached quickly to help. Countries like Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Indonesia all have been helped by the Indian Navy ships when natural disasters struck their country. The Indian Navy is a friendly force in the Indian Ocean region, but one that needs to transform itself quickly in the face of a very aggressive China. Which is why the Andaman Nicobar Islands are of strategic importance to India and its security.